When someone lands on your GitHub profile, you only get one chance to make a first impression, and typically, first impressions are decided within 10 to 30 seconds. In this video, we're going to be building a professional GitHub profile, so when they land on your GitHub page, they can know a little bit more about you. So we'll go all the way from zero, all the way to hero, adding images, using Markdown to really customize our page, and even adding GIFs if we want to showcase off our projects. This way, people at a glance can get to know a little bit more about you, and you can really rock that first impression. So if you want to learn how to build something like this, let's go ahead and dive on in. Okay, the first step is to log on into GitHub, and you can go to your profile, and typically on your profile, if you haven't made a README, you'll just see your contributions, some of your public repos, etc. To create the README, we're going to create a new repository in the top right, so make sure you're signed on into GitHub. If you don't have a GitHub account, today is the day. We're going to be creating a new repository. For the repository name, you're going to name it the exact same as your GitHub profile, case sensitive. So for me, that'd be NDC Swift. And we'll see when we add our name, it is a special repository that we can add as a README to our profile. So we need to make sure that the visibility is on public. And under the add README, we need to make sure that's on. We're only going to be using a README in this repository today. Go ahead and create that repository. And we have a default README that says hide there. We're definitely going to want to edit this file. So we can press the little pencil button to edit the file, and it's going to take us to a placeholder. And this placeholder isn't too terrible. As something to note, when we're using the README, it's a .md file, which means that it's a Markdown file. If this is your first time using Markdown, I'd recommend heading on over to markdownguide.org, link in the description below, and heading on over to the cheat sheet. This is going to give you an overview of the basic syntax, so you can learn how to use headings, quotes, even inserting links or images. There's also the extended syntax, which is pretty cool. Now, because we are running this on a website, we also have a little bit of HTML integration. Now we can't run anything like scripts, but we can add links, we can even center using paragraphs or alignments. So here's an example of a pretty basic GitHub README. We have the hashtag in order to represent the header. We have the double hashtag for the header too, as we can see on the cheat sheet. We've also included a link. I just put down the checkout Markdown guide for more tips, and then I'm actually using HTML in order to bold some text within it with the B, and I'm also using the italics with HTML. So let's say this is our README, we're happy with it. We can then commit our changes. Let's go ahead and push that one directly. And now we can see, welcome to my GitHub profile, and we can see the styling from the Markdown. If we were to go back to our profile, now, when people visit our page, we can see here that we have this welcome to my GitHub profile README being displayed. We can even see that we have our link here. We can click on it and open up the Markdown guide. You may want to choose a link to a repository or any other external information that you have. Now, this is a very, very basic README. It's the job done. You can put a little bit about who you are, the projects you're working on, what you're looking to collaborate on, etc. Let's go ahead and edit it a little bit more. This is how I would take the next step in your README. We've added a header 3 for about me, you know, your aspiring developer, learning about new technologies. And then we've used these three lines here. And these three lines, if we go back to our cheat sheet, represent the horizontal rule. Go ahead and commit and see what this looks like. We can see that we have the horizontal rule kind of acting as a divider between the different sections. We have a little bit about me. Of course, you'd probably want to spruce it up about yourself. What are your interests? What are you passionate about? Maybe a couple hobbies for fun. And then you can have some projects. You can also link these to any GitHub repos if you have stuff live on the App Store, Steam, whatever platform they may live on. You can also include a little contact if you want to have people reach you on LinkedIn or check out your code on GitHub. Might be a little redundant to have that if they're already on your profile, but maybe a certain repository you can link them to. So that's the next step, I'd say. We went from beginner to intermediate, and now let's talk about taking it to the next level of pro. This is my current GitHub README page, and I might make some changes in the future. That's when we get into the tips, really having this be a living kind of always being updated README is a really good idea. So what I've done, and I'll kind of show you the visuals and then we'll go into the code, is I've added an image banner. This is the same banner from my YouTube channel. Very, very simple at a glance with my Dream Big, Code Bigger tagline that I say at the end of every video. I have an about me, a little bit about what I like to do, teaching with my YouTube. You might even want to celebrate certain milestones here. The first cool thing I want to talk about is under the tech and tools, I've included these little kind of icons. Now you can access these icons by going on over to shields.io. Any link is going to be in the description below and pressing get started. From here, there's tons of information on how you can actually create these static badges. At the most simplest way, you'll see that we want a label, optional message, and color separated by dashes. So let's say we're passionate about SwiftUI. We do SwiftUI, then dash, orange. We'll change to Markdown, as that's what we're using today. We'll then press execute. And we can see here we have this little badge. You can also then copy this link and head on back over to your Markdown file, and then you would be including that link. Now for me, I've actually been doing this with HTML because I have these set up as links. So when I press on the link, we can see here that I get taken to the SwiftUI website. But these are really cool if you want to add a little bit extra flair to your profile. Again, I'm using the kind of divider here with the three dashes. Under the projects, I've opted to include some just little sample GIF demos of some of the app features in action. I've then aligned them with center. Afterwards, I've included the GIF. So again, I'm using that HTML and Markdown in tandem because it's being displayed on a website. The way I've created these is I've actually just used a video to GIF conversion. If you want to do this quickly on Mac, you could do Command Shift 5. You can then choose what you want to record, whether that's the selected portion, a window, or the entire screen. So if I were to just record myself going through a portion of my app, displaying a little bit of TapDuel here, we're all good. I can then save the recording. This will then get added to my desktop. On Windows, you can use Window Shift R all at once to bring up the recording window, then select what you want to record, hit the record button. When you're all finished, you can hit the stop recording button. From there, you'll be able to access the recordings folder by default under your videos, screen recordings folder. You can see here, you can open it and we now have our video. Next step, you'll want to use a video to GIF converter. I've just used GIFSKI. Now this is also available for both Windows or on macOS from the App Store. So we'll open GIFSKI up. I'm just going to drag and drop the video we just created on in. And we can actually even choose to trim the video if we really want. So if I want to start it from when I'm starting reflex mode and then all the way to when it shows me the time. You can even adjust things like the FPS and the speed, the quality, make sure it loops forever. Let's go ahead and convert it real quick. Should only take a few moments. I think because I'm recording video, it's probably taking up a little bit of processing power on my Mac. And there we go. We get a little check mark. We can choose to save. So I'm just going to save this on my desktop. And now we have our GIF. You'll need to post this on an image hosting service, whether that's Imgur. I've actually just added these GIFs to my Swift project repo. So if we go ahead and look at this GIF here. So from there, you can right click and then copy image address, and you can use that URL. Once you have the URL, you can then include it as an image. I would suggest, because they're often a little bit large, adjusting the width a little bit. So here I have three GIFs that are playing side by side. So if we look at that on the profile, you can see I have the GIFs. I think this is a pretty cool way to showcase your projects. Afterwards, I have a little bit more about the apps on the app stores, including the links to all of them. I've then also chosen to have a work in progress section. This allows people to see a little bit about what I'm working on that's, you know, maybe not quite ready for public release. So here I have the kitty game and micro goal, again with another little GIF. This one's pretty small. I then have the connect with me, including my YouTube and website, so people can click on these links, again made with that shield.io, so a little bit more visually appealing. I then have some GitHub stats, and you can grab this, again link in the description below, by just including a GitHub README stats and changing and updating your username. So if we go to the actual repository here, we can see the GitHub README stats and how to use it. Just make sure that you add it on in. And then under the username, just put whatever your GitHub username is, and you'll have this fun little GitHub stats. And then finally, for me, I've also included some of my latest YouTube videos. again combining Markdown and HTML in order to make sure that the videos aren't too large, and I have 3 videos there. So link for anything we talked about in the description below. And now I just want to talk a little bit about some tips and tricks. I'll also put a scaffolded readme of my final product here without all my information in it. So if you want to use that to get started, feel free to do so. All right, so those are the basics. Definitely take some time to really curate this using Markdown, a little bit of HTML. Remember, no scripts, just some styling from HTML. Think of this as a landing page. People scanning your profile, again, will spend about 10 to 30 seconds before deciding if they want to explore more. Structure it so your most important highlights are at the top. So here I have the about me, my tech and tools, and then my project. So at a glance, you can kind of see a little bit about what I'm about. If you're interested in learning more, then you can scroll down, seeing, you know, things like my work in progresses or, you know, my latest YouTube videos. But for the most important parts, about me, quick little quip, and then some tech and tools, why not? You can also use the visual hierarchy. So using clear headings, so here I have the about me, my projects, tech and tools, makes it really easy to skim. You can break text into short paragraphs or even bullet points, so nothing feels like a wall of text. Also feel free to use emojis and icons, use them a bit sparingly. Makes it a little bit more engaging. I like to include them in the headers, but it's totally up to you. It also includes some brand consistency. So match this readme's tone and visuals with whatever your branding is. So for me, that's by using my YouTube banner, so it feels a little bit more cohesive. Even my profile picture being my little Memoji that's included in my thumbnails, right? It's a good idea to have some branding here. And even the shield badges are pretty cool if you do want to have a certain branding consistency. Also, highlight what matters. My YouTube career is pretty important to me, so I try to make it shine by including the links here and even having the dedicated version at GitHub Stats. Maybe if there's an achievement, like just hitting 1,000 subs, woo, thank you so much for the subscribes, by the way, I might also want to include that now. Think of this like a portfolio showcase, and it doesn't just have to be about your repositories. What is something else that you're proud of in your career or development journey? If you want to add the interactivity, things like the GitHub Stats can add a little bit more credibility, or just at a glance show a little bit more about what you've been doing in the community. Even a quick connect with me, you know, again, I have my YouTube and my website available here. If you want to have, you know, LinkedIn, Twitter, etc., and allows people to just quickly connect with you at a glance. Also, keep it fresh. Avoid making this something that's static. People can tell if a readme hasn't been touched in years, which is why I plan to keep my projects up to date. So the more things that I do complete, I'll put here if I do have any public repositories, as well as updating work in progress. I want people to know what I'm working on. If someone comes to my profile and then 3 months later comes back and sees a different project being worked on, or seeing maybe kitty game being completed, it keeps it lively without having to update it constantly. Just whenever you hit a milestone or you start working on something else, why not celebrate it on your readme? You can also add a personal touch, whether that's a fun fact, your favorite anime or game, short line about your vision. Keep it professional, but not robotic. It's all about authenticity. As little bonus tips, right, those shield icons that we added, those GIFs, you know, maybe some apps or programs and actions, maybe blog posts if you start writing on, you know, dev.to or Medium. You can really make your GitHub readme your own, and I just think it's pretty cool. I love going to someone's page and seeing a nice blurb about them, not just being shown about you know, their public repos and all the commits that they had made. I want to learn a little bit more about them right away. Now go on and create your own profile readme, and drop a link in the comments so others can check it out too if you want to. Thanks again so much for 1,000 subscribers. Dream big, code bigger, and we'll see you in the next one.